Waiting at the striker's end. Got him. Yes, he's out. Breaking catch. That could change the course of the match.
He got into a great position to take that catch. There's plenty of time left, so I guess the message is don't take any risks.
We're about to see a change in the bowling. One, he'll be trying to bowl into the rough. He'll be aiming for that rough patch. Well, he'll be aiming for that rough stuff. One, he'll be trying to pitch the ball into the rough. He'll be aiming for that rough patch. He'll be trying to pitch the ball into the rough. He'll be trying to pitch the ball into the rough. He'll be trying to bowl into the rough.
Lazy. That's the truth, and he'll regret it when he sees the replay. You can't keep a good man down. There's a 5-wicket haul for Shane Warne, the master. Certainly the greatest of all leg spinners, arguably the greatest bowler of all time, and he has another 5-wicket haul to his name here today. We've seen all the variations too, a ripping leg break, the odd googly, plenty of top spinners. Yep, no issue. Warne is still the boss.
Lee is going to try over the wicket. Edged and safe. Lee is going to try over the wicket. Lee is coming around the wicket. Edged and out. Lovely catch. He's got a great pair of hands.
Now have a look at this again. That is a good example of how to take a catch. Geraint Jones is out then, trying to hit Shane Warne down the ground. That was a steady catch from Michael Kasprovich. The tail is under such pressure. Still 13 needed to seal victory for England as Brett Lee starts a new over to Matthew Hoggard. Australia are proving just what a good and fighting side they are, and suddenly they have a real chance of stealing this win away from England.